It all began in darkness. I awoke to a world of pain. A throbbing in my head pounded on my temples. Suddenly, I saw white light approaching me. I saw a human form within that light. An angel. The shining light radiated something soothing.
Eric.
The angel spoke to me.
Eric, it's time.
The angel disappeared, and the hammering became more intense. Faster. Slowly, my sight returned. A rhythm and different sounds, which slowly coalesced to become music. The darkness slowly gave way to blurry surroundings, focused on regaining my orientation. All around me, I could see people, bodies twitching, moving to the rhythm of the music. I felt sick, but at least I could move again. I needed to run some water over my head. That would do me good. Barely stand, and the nausea was getting stronger. Gathering the last of my strength, I dragged myself on.
Your assignment is waiting.
Eric. Eric Bane. The name shot through my head like a bullet. It was my name, other memories. Nothing. The darkness in my head veiled everything. The angel was gone, and so was the pain. It was time to find out who I was. Or what I was doing here. Chances were the bouncer had seen me come in. Maybe he could shed some light on the subject.
Get out of my face! We don't need an audience.
Hi.
Yeah? What do you want?
I wanted to ask. I couldn't get another word out. The sight of his weapon woke some kind of memory.
Hey, man. You okay?
Yeah. It's okay. I'm doing fine. Did I come to the club alone, or was someone with me?
No idea. My shift had only just begun. My boss was watching the door before that.
Where can I find him?
Well, he's sure to be hanging around here somewhere. Ask at the bar for Tom.
That flashback had felt pretty damn realistic, even if I didn't completely understand it. What should I make of it? I made my way back into the club to find the head of security. Maybe he would be able to help me. Hi. I'll have a...
You'll have a Bloody Mary. House style.
Who said I wanted a Bloody Mary?
Believe me, I know exactly what you want.
Do you know where Tom is?
Tom? Yes, I do happen to know where Tom is. Head upstairs and you'll find him. Good luck.
Okay, catch you later.
Yes. See you later.
The stuff tasted disgusting, and it had a strange aftertaste. However, my body saw it differently, and a pleasant warmth spread through me.
Hey, man. You okay?
Have we met?
Not directly, but don't we all know one another somehow? I mean, we're practically one big family.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Shit, man, you really don't know, do you?
My memory is a bit foggy at the moment.
Sure, whatever. I know exactly what you mean. Look, we can help you, man. I mean, I know someone who can. Follow me, dude. I'll take you to her. I'm sure she'll help you. Her name's Rose, and she knows more about that stuff than the rest of us. Hey, man. You were really lucky to meet me. There's some of us out there that are real bad news, dude. They would have just ripped your head off or something. Don't worry. We're almost there. What? By the way, Rose, she owns the sanctuary.
Pretty.
Run with me. Run with me. I'm
born against you emptiness. Hi, Tom. I see you brought a guest. Nice to see you again. Was the drink okay?
Hey, Rose. This dude has, like, got no idea what's happening. Can't remember a damn thing.
And he's here all alone?
Looks like it.
Hello, I'm still here. Could you tell me what's going on? I have no idea what you're talking about.
You're a...
vampire. A vampire, like Tom and me.
Yeah, right. Thanks for the drink. And no offense, but I'll just be going now.
Tom, show him.
Hey, neat trick, man.
What?
You automatically resorted to your vampire abilities out of pure reflex. Not bad. You seem to be a natural. Thank you, Tom. I'll take care of our guests now. You can go back.
Yo, later, man.
So?
My name is Eric. Eric Bain.
Well, Eric, I'm Rose. I hope our little demonstration convinced you.
I don't think I have any alternative.
That is correct. Right now, you also have a much bigger problem you need to take care of. You are not yet a fully fledged vampire, and that has some drawbacks.
How come I'm not a full vampire yet?
If a vampire drinks your blood and kills you in the process, you will turn into a vampire yourself. However, that alone does not complete the transformation. First, you have to drink your creator's blood. Only then will you be a full-fledged vampire.
And since I don't know who made me a vampire, that's kind of a problem.
Exactly. A vampire doesn't just create another vampire for no reason. We try to hide our very existence from humans, and every newcomer increases the risk of being discovered. Your creator put us all at risk when he just left you behind. No vampire would willingly call down the wrath of all the others upon himself. I suppose something must have happened to him.
And what happens if I don't drink his blood?
You really don't want to know. I have no idea exactly what happens when someone becomes a vampire, but if you do not get the right blood, your brain starts to deteriorate. You will become more and more of an animal, until you finally lose all of your humanity. We call these pitiful creatures ghouls. Believe me, you want to avoid becoming one of those creatures at all costs.
Do I have any options?
Ah, yes. The blood of an ancient and powerful vampire can theoretically replace your creator's blood. But I'm talking about vampires that have been in the business for several decades. You won't find anyone like that in the sanctuary, but I do know of someone. His name is John Blooming. He's the director of the Harding Museum downtown. Blooming is not a nice man. He's not likely to give you his blood voluntarily.
It's not as if I have much of a choice.
That is certainly true. However, you should talk to Tom before you head out. He can give you a few tips.
Hey, you're Eric, right? I don't have much time. As you can see, I'm kind of busy.
See you around.
Yeah, sure.
Hey, man. Everything okay?
Rose said you could teach me something more.
Not really teach, you know. But I got an idea about how you can train your intuitive reflexes. There's a few thugs hanging around out front of the club. Maybe you could check it out.
Sounds good to me.
All right, man. Good luck.
I found myself in a deserted alley. Tom had sent me here for training. Something was wrong. I staggered down the only way I could find.
Hey, man, you look pretty messed up.
How about it, sucker? You got some change?
That's right, man. Give us your money, or you are so toast!
I felt anger rise in me, a desire to hurt someone, and a craving for blood.
What kind of sick shit is this?
I couldn't explain what had just happened. Had I just killed someone and drank his blood?
I'm telling you, the bastard done Mikey! Tore his fucking throat out!
Okay, man, calm down. We'll keep you safe. If he comes over here, we'll take him out.
Something's here. Ah, man, now I'm imagining things.
You.
Your worst nightmare.
Thank you.
Welcome back, Eric.
I'm ready.
Excellent. Good luck. How do you rate your chances?
I'll make it through.
Whatever you want. I'll give you a radio so we can stay in touch. And I'm pretty good with computers. Maybe I can help you out a little. Good luck, Eric.
I made my way to the museum and thought about what Rose had said. Vampire. The idea was absurd, incredible, but the evidence was overwhelming and irrefutable. I was hoping that someone would come and tell me it was all just one big joke, but no one came. For now, I would have to accept it and focus on my goal. The Harding Museum rose before me like a quiet rock, impervious to the approaching storm. At least that's what I thought.